Here we are, and we're going to continue our studies here. And learning how to keep myself going slow now, because I got more motivation to do this. Alrighty. Okay, so you hear defined words. So now we know why Obama is at the top here with a and like I said, that video came to me by surprise. It was a synchronicity of the universe that started playing that video on YouTube's new automatic play function. And it just so happened to be that I was looking up this word spoiled. And the reason why I was looking up the word spoiled was because I had a free Zodiac reading. And she sent it through the email, and one of the analysis was that I was spoiled. So it made me want to look it up and see what spoiled actually is, because I was feeling depressed because of it. And so... And then I actually healed myself and brought myself out of the state of depression by looking up the word. And that led me to the word indulge. And then that led me to the next word of grandiose. See if I can move that off to the side. To the next word of... emotions repressed. And then the next word was narcissism. Next word, egocentricism. And then transitive was the next word. Then absolutism. Sun-centered body. And partial order, total order, mathematical object. That led me to abstract object, which led me to the philosophy of mathematics, which led to methodology. Led to knowledge, which led to awareness, uploading that other video, which led to object, which led to pattern, which led to template, to stencil, to pigment, to color, to visual perception, to property, to incorporeal, to corporate, to real property, subset of land, possessory, and then ultimately sovereignty. So you can see how the universe took me through feeling depressed, all the way down to feeling totally balanced. And the thing that got me feeling good right off the bat Must have been indulge. Yeah. I made some new pictures yesterday. So now just me going over these things again over and over is reminding myself and creating repetitive brain patterns. Maybe it was in grandiose, emotions repressed. Narcissism. Seems like I made more pictures yesterday. And they seem to be not there. I thought they were in the spoiled section. Let's look up spoiled here. Okay, doing this. Went over that one yesterday. Okay, so that was that. Let's see here. So now I know why the universe sent this Obama video, was because it was synchronizing with my own feelings of depression. And basically, that's what Obama was feeling. It's a depressed feeling. It's just a different degree of depression that he was in. He had other elements mixed into his depression. But still, it's that same sinking feeling. It's a feeling of gravity. Oh, indulge. Here they are. Oh, here's the pictures that I made. Okay. To yield to an inclination or desire. So once I read that, I was like, oh, shoot, that makes me feel good. And then this one, to yield to satisfy or gratify desires. Because desires is the key word to the law of attraction. So, transitive, to yield excessively to the wishes of. And to me, in my own mind, I was saying to myself, yeah, I want to yield totally to the feeling of unattachment in total rest and peace. Not trying to make my point across so much, but to be general. And to learn how to just let the universe speak to other people's minds. And just speak these things for my own benefit. But yet, realizing at the same time that other people are going to see it. So to put my intention of love into my presentations so that intention is picked up by them. It's like a radio wave frequency, a signal, radio signal. I'm radiating like a sun radiates heat. So and then I came across this one. Commerce, to grant an extension of time for payment or performance to person, a company, or on a bill, notes, etc. So that told me, you know, hey man, you got all the time in the world to pay for things. Because the way that our system is set up, it's set up on a promise to pay system, which means you can put things off into the future. And since how the future is unlimited, you can postpone payment for an unlimited amount of time. So you can do with that what you want. Then there's these different websites that I put in here. This is where I got my pictures from, so we've seen that website. Indulge here, so to yield to an inclination or desire. So we can see that that's where I took a picture of that one. I made a record of my sources for my pictures. Or I made a record for the sources. I made a record of the sources for the pictures. They're not my pictures. They're the pictures. To indulge in excess. Now that would be a negative one. Because that makes me think of being spoiled now. To be a spoiled rotten brat. And then there's this one, to be transitive, to yield excessively to the wishes of. And when I read that one, the universe put a picture in my mind of, oh yeah, that's a good one. Because you see, I'm putting my own definition on these words. And all I'm doing is just looking for universal words to make me feel good. Because that's the whole name of the game of life, is just feeling good. The more we feel good, the more the universe will grant our desires. When I say grant, I say that the universe has the power to take away. Because that's what a grant is. The one who gives the grant has the power to take the grant back. And that just goes along with, if we harm someone in the public, then the universe is going to suspend some of our desires. It's like when your child, your parent suspends you for being bad and says go to your room, or takes away your guitar, takes things away from you that you love to do. So that's a grant. That's the basis of all grants. If you get a grant of money to open a business and then you do some bad things in your business, well then the grantor can take back that money and pretty much close your business down. So, if you look into the fine print of a grant, just because someone grants you money doesn't mean that you have that money free and clear. There are hidden contracts behind those grants that you don't know about that will be popped out into the open and shown to you if need be, if you screw up. And on those contracts that you signed, deep, deep, deep in the hidden print of their definition of what's on that contract, their definition is, we have the power to sue you if you think you can just take our money and do anything you want with your business. And that's the bottom line. And Mother Nature and Father Cause puts these boundaries in place. Because if we decide to be unpeaceful and break our international peace treaties, which is our security agreement and our personal commercial lien, then Mother Nature and Father Cause will attract to us what our thoughts are. If their thoughts are harm, well, she's going to bring the public attorney. And they will give you all kinds of trouble. And not only that, will the public attorneys give you trouble, but Mother Nature will give you trouble as well. And she will do such things as send a storm to your house and have a tornado touch down and just take your house out and nobody else's. And that's called the law of attraction. As you think, so the universe will attract to you. So, and that led me to this one word, grandiose, because grandiose was in one of the definitions for spoiled in the Wikipedia manual. So, grandiose says here refers to unrealistic sense of superiority, a sustained view of oneself as better than the others that causes the narcissist to view others with a disdain or as inferior, as well as to a sense of uniqueness. See? Now all I got to do is take that word right there, sense of uniqueness, and that automatically brings me into the positive now. And I think to myself, oh, okay. So grandiose has a good side to it. It's a sense of uniqueness. So, all I got to do is just take a picture of that. And there it is right there. And then I just save this to my hard drive. How do we spell unique? N-U-N-I-C. Q-U-E-N. Unick, Q-U-E-N. Okay, so unick, Q-U-E-N-E-S-S, uniqueness. So I'll now put that in my astrology, Russell Zodiac, emails, definition of words, grandiose. And it should drop right in the file there, and there it is. Bring it up. There it is. Sense of uniqueness. So I'm defining these words for myself. So remember, that's what we want to do in life, is we want to put the definition on our words. So I want to show you something here. Like I was telling you, I wrote some trust checks to the bank, and one of them was to the DMV, and I was using the power of my thoughts to have the DMV honor my check, and they honored it halfway, even though they sent me a collection for a bad check, a bill in the mail. They still honored the plate. So what I want to do is I want to show you the first two letters of the plate. And the first two letters is HD. See that? HD. And to me, when I saw that, I saw the word high definition. So there we are. There's my presidential seal. I am a DOJ level attorney now. Well, I always was, but I am a straw man. This is my straw man. I am a DOJ level attorney straw man. And there it is. So, and just to let you see, here's the stickers. Six, 16. 'Cause that's the month of my the vehicle that I hold title to, 616. So, even though the check was returned, that was a dishonor on the bank's part, but I got a IRS criminal investigation on the bank for that dishonor. So we're gonna see how the universe handles that as I start feeling more better and better here. So let me go put these back on the shelf. Like I said, those are just my pub. That's just the public straw man that I hold title to. I am the living man, and when you get to a certain level of understanding, you realize that you can be a living man and operate your corporation in Mother Nature and Father Cause's universe. So, until such time as we don't need the corporation anymore, and we are going to get there. So, and then the next one, whoops, I need to make that like that. Okay, so I just created a new neural pathway. I just told myself that I'm unique. Okay, and emotions repressed. That was the title for this one. Physicians can counsel parents in the proper ways to deal with their children to prevent spoiling as follows. Up to the age of six, a parent need not worry that comforting a crying child will result in spoiling. but after that time they should encourage children to comfort themselves. And that was the main thing that I was looking at. So, it is good to comfort the child at first, but after that time, they should encourage the children to comfort themselves, because the children, it's good for them to be able to stand on their own to deal with their emotions. For instance, if a child falls over and hurts his knee, scrapes his knee up, there comes a point in time where we need to let the child cry his own tears, feel his own pain, be uninfluenced by any outside effects, by any parents or sisters or brothers or any passerbyers. The child should be able to sit there and learn how to rub his own hand over his knee, you know, heal himself, use his own thoughts, start healing himself, and start dealing with his pain. He might have to embrace the feelings of pain. And if the child has learned how to embrace the feelings of pain, then the child can move on to the next step of how to use his mind to start to feel good. Training his mind to move in the direction of feeling good. So, that's why I wrote that one. So I'm going to take a picture of this one too. So I'll call Child Comfort Himself number 2. Child Comfort Himself number 2. Should be able to see it inside here now. There it is. Alright. And then we got this one. Okay, this one says, children with underlying medical or mental health problems may exhibit some of the symptoms, speech or hearing disorders, and attention deficit disorder. May lead to children's failing to understand the limits set by parents. Children who have recently experienced a stressful event, such as the separation of the parent, divorce, or the birth or death of a close family relative, may also exhibit some of all these symptoms. Children of parents who themselves have psychiatric disorders may manifest some of the symptoms because the parents have erratically sometimes failing to perceive their children's behavior correctly. Now, the reason that I put this in the file was because it was just a reminder that parents have in the past allowed the children to develop in an unhealthy way. So but also at the same time children, see, now I'm going to want to make a note. So now I need to bring up a new folder. Nope, I didn't want to do that. New window. text full. I want to type in here a note, and we're going to capture this on picture too. Parents. Should allow children to do what they desire. That was the main gist I remember of why I Number two, it is good to lightly guide children if children do extreme violence. That's when, or oh, okay, hold on. If children break the peace. Break the peace. Or extreme or cause harm. Let's just do that. There we go. So let's do this again and write it in better language. Parents should allow children to do what they desire. Let's get rid of that word should and put a pause there so it's in the mood of a request. So it actually reads like this. Parents, allow children to do what they desire. Let's just put this, accomplish. Accomplish desires. There we go. Parents, allow children to accomplish desires. Number two, it's good to lightly guide children if the children break the peace or cause harm. All right. So we'll put that there. And we'll save this in the file. We'll just say children's peace. Desires. Now we'll take a picture. Whoops. Let's put this over here so we can see. Get me on the screen here. Actually, we'll put this at the bottom, put this at the top. And we'll take a picture of this. And we'll call this one Children, Peace, Desires. So I'll copy that, paste it up into here. We'll call it, that'll be the TIFF, so it'll automatically put its own on the end there. There we go. And so now we can bring up the TIFF, and there it is. Parents allow children to accomplish desires. It's good to lightly guide children. The children break the peace. If the children break the peace. Whoops. Correct that. If the children break the peace. Take another picture of that. Have it. Now we can save that and replace it. And get rid of that. And save this one. Replace it. That. So now let's bring it back up. If is still there. And there it is. If the children. So it's good if the children break the harm, break the peace, or cause harm. So these are basic family rules. So, all right, so that's that. Yeah, we do want to save it. Okay, so we finished with the grandiose, and we finished with the repressed emotions. Grandiose, repressed emotions. Let's do this. Go all the way back to the beginning. it's not letting me get all the way back to the beginning. Let's just bring up a new one. There we go. I'm going to slide that over there. Russell Zodiac, email, defined words. There we go. And we were at repressed. Wanted to be able to do that. There we go. Now we can read everything. All right. Narcissism is the next one. Let's see what this is all about. Is the pursuit of gratification from vanity or egotistic admiration of one's own attributes? The term originated in the Greek mythology, where the young narcissist fell in love with his own image reflection in the pool of waters. Okay, now let's figure out, see if I can remember why I put this one in there. Narcissism is the pursuit of gratification from vanity or egocentric admiration of one's own attributes. So that right there says it all. Now, when I read the word from, it automatically registered in my mind as to separate from. Now, some people's minds, when they read this word from, the word from right here, they could read it as an inclusion, to include yourself in. But my mind was already hardwired to read it as an exclusion. So I saw it as a good thing. Narcissism is the pursuit of gratification, to separate oneself from vanity or egotistic admiration. Not to totally separate himself, but to balance. So, I could actually get me a better definition here. Something tells me it's not going to allow me to do it unless I go all the way down here. And open up the window. There we go. Okay, so what I need to do is actually take a picture of this. So let's highlight it. Get a picture of it. Label on it, and let's see what it say. Oh, pursuit of gratification from ego. Pursue gratification. So, narcissism, we'll put that in there. Now we can bring it up. So I'm going to put the picture up here, and I'm going to type in here. The word from can be defined as a inclusive, b exclusive. Example. Two. And then what I'll do is I'll just copy and paste this right here in the sentence. There's one. We'll do a three here. So now that we have everything there, narcissism is the pursuit of gratification. Equalize. See, narcissism is the pursuit of gratification from, would be okay. Now I gotta slow down here. Okay, I couldn't see it. I could only see it when I was reading it on here. Narcissism is the pursuit of gratification from. Oh, to get gratification. From one's own attributes. Okay. To get gratification from one's attributes. Also, it could mean to separate oneself from the from vanity. But to maintain balance. Because we need our ego it is, it represents the body, and we need the body to enjoy our earth. Okay, so let me save that. Is that the one I was in? Yeah. Yep. Okay, so I need to pursue gratification. Pursue gratification. All right. So we'll save that in there. So now we can finish it up. Narcissism is the pursuit from gratification. From is defined as, and we'll save that. From is defined as to get gratification from one's attributes, to separate oneself from vanity. And then we'll put that quotations around it so that it accents that word, to separate oneself from vanity. To separate oneself from vanity. So you can see right there, we need to add some clarification to our English language. Such as, when you see words and quotations like this, we need to use the musical tones in a particular way when we speak the word. To separate. Separate. So we actually need to put musical notes. Separate. Because those are musical tones that I'm speaking. Separate. This has to do with Pythagorean math that's connected to music. Separate, because this has to do with the origin of all language, and that is the intention or the tone that we put in our voice when we speak words. Separate oneself from vanity. Whereas if I was to speak it like this, to separate oneself from vanity, then it just glosses over the definition of what separation really is. When I use this tone, to separate oneself from vanity, and then to put a pause after it, to separate, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, to separate, because that's a musical rest right there. So we need musical notes. We need a shift for musical notes on our keyboards. To separate oneself from vanity, but to maintain balance, because we do, so you can see the tone that I used on that word, do. We do, whereas if I was just to read it like this, because we do need our ego. See, there's a difference in the pronunciation there. We do need our ego. So I'm just going to put quotes around that. We do need our ego. And then there's some space. There's a rest right there. We do need our ego. It represents the body. And see, you can see I put emphasis on that word body. It represents the body. So, all in all, this sentence reads like this. Narcissism is the pursuit of gratification from vanity or egotistic admiration of one's own attributes. Now, when we go down to the second one, this was an example of inclusion. So, we're going to say of inclusion. Okay, so this next one's going to be the example of exclusion. Example of exclusion. So, narcissism. Let's do that. Let's put some more space in there because that makes it feel, gives it some breathing room. Bring this one up. Example of inclusion, example of exclusion. Oh, we lost the size of our letters right here, so let's increase the font on that one. Let's put that in bold. So now we're writing a book. So narcissism is the pursuit. Narcissism is the pursuit from gratification. Meaning, now I'm reading the first one again. From is defined to get gratification from one's attributes, to separate oneself from vanity, but to maintain balance. Okay, thus we are not completely separating ourselves from ego. For if we do, we lose our body to death. And we don't want to lose our body to death because we want to stay alive forever. We enjoy having our bodies. So now in exclusion, narcissism is the pursuit of gratification from, meaning to separate ourselves from the popular interpretation of vanity. Ah, shit, what the hell? See, this is why I say we need a window, a screen window of what we're typing to be placed right at the top of our keyboards right up here. See that? We need a window right here that's typing just as we type so we can see it. So, because it's so easy to get lost in typing, the cursor just goes all over the screen and jumps everywhere sometimes. So to separate oneself from the popular interpretation of vanity. Vanity is seen as a negative trait in society. Because vanity can represent selfishness, the type that leads to unpeacefulness and causes harm in the public. So, there we got that. Unpeacefulness. So let's save that. Okay, so here we are. To separate oneself from the popular interpretation of vanity. Vanity is seen as a negative trait in society because vanity can represent selfishness, the type that leads to unpeacefulness and causes harm in the public. This needs to be a semicolon. Popular interpretation of vanity. And we'll put a capitalize on there. Vanity is seen as a negative trait in society because vanity can represent selfishness, the type that leads to unpeacefulness and causes harm in the public. All right. So, if we put that there, and then we bring up the picture, okay. Put the picture down here. We can put it up here. And then we can put this right here. Now we can actually make that smaller. So we'll just leave it about like that. So we can put it right up here. Good, so we can take that up a little bit. That way we can get a nice big picture of this. And this will be the last picture that we're going to take here. Then we're going to take a break. I'll do that. Let's do this again. Don't want to save that little piece. I want to get a better. There we go. There it is. Okay, what do we want to label this? Pursue gratification number 2. All right. Okay. So so let's bring that up. Pursue gratification number 2. And there it is. So everything's there. And let's make a folder for these ones. Fall in love with my body. So basically, yeah. Fall in love with my body. And that's what we want to do. We want to love ourselves. Whoops. So we'll. No, that was the website. Put those in there. So that way I'll just imprint it on my memory that this one is the website. This one is the picture. And this is just my first attempt at at the pictures. It includes the write-up that I did. All right. So that's good enough. So let's get all this stuff off the screen. Now, as I'm doing this, I can feel my overworking myself, over-tensing myself. So let's just end the video here because I need some rest. Alrighty. And you can see my computer starting to drag. That tells me that my computer is telling me that I'm starting to drag. And it's because I'm dragging, my computer's dragging. So.